Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Chapter some basic principles and techniques in organic chemistry, and we are doing the topic free radical. Hello friends, now we are going to discuss about free radical, and this free radical, this word is what we have got to know when a homolytic fission was been occurring for a particular reactant, and in that case also we have got to know the free radical. But what is the actual meaning of the free radical and how it has been formed? So let us talk about that. So talking about the free radical, that is an uncharged species which is electrically neutral and contains a single electron is called as free radical. So this is what we have explained earlier also, but let me give an example of the another one. That is, so in the previous lecture, that is when we have understood that is what is homolytic fission of the ethane. So in that case, we have got to know that is when ethane undergoes the homolytic fission. So that in that case, we have got to know that the methyl radical has been formed. So that is CH3 dot plus CH3. So it is the representation of the radical, and if you observe this radical, then this radical is basically the uncharged species which is electrically neutral. The reason behind that is it is uncharged species because, as you could see, because the homolytic fission has been occurred in this case, so therefore each carbon atom that has been present over here has got its own electron, and that is the reason that the particular carbon atom is not losing its electron so as to form carbocation, or not that carbon atom is been acquiring the other electron so as to form carboanion. So that is the reason it is not acquiring either positive charge nor negative charge. But yes, one thing is sure, that this is neutral. The reason behind that is it has its own electron. But what makes this to be more unstable? So that is what we are going to find out over here. So talking about the methyl radical, as I have mentioned over here, so we could write the structure of that, and it would be very much easy to understand it. How? So that is, if I am talking about the carbon atom, so again the carbon atom is the one which will acquire six electrons in it, so therefore that could be written as 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. And meanwhile we could write the orbital form also, so therefore in this case the p shell will acquire, we know it will give three orbitals, while this is been occupied by the two electrons, and the p is been occupied by also the two electrons, as we could see over here. And but the hydrogen that has been connected or that has been attached to the carbon is 3. So suppose in this case, suppose a hybridization would occur, and in that case we will get to know that is the hybridization that is occurring in the methyl radical is nothing but the sp2 hybridization, and in that case we will get the similar concept while compared to that of methyl cation, and that's the reason that we could see that the both will have the same kind of hybridization, that is sp2 hybridization. So let me give you more detail about this thing. That is, suppose if the excitation takes place in such a manner that one of the electron occupies this p orbital, so therefore after excitation we could see, I'm just giving an information whether to make understand that why this is basically more unstable. So suppose this is the electron of the carbon that has been acquired in an excited state, so therefore this is the excited state. And so let me introduce the hydrogen. But as we could see that there are three hydrogen that have been mentioned over here, so therefore this is the for one hydrogen, and this is for next, and this is, so this is how I have got basically sp2 hybridized. So I'm just giving it just small synopsis. So this is what we have got, sp2 hybridization, and we could see that one electron is being as it is, so therefore this is an odd electron that has been present in the carbon atom during the formation of a methyl radical. So that makes that extra electron, that makes it unstable. The reason behind that is if one hydrogen would have been occupied here, then it would have been completed its octet, and that's the reason that the outermost shell would have been with the overall of because now it is for a particular carbon, so suppose if I would say for a particular carbon it is four electrons, but because of the three hydrogen atoms came with their electron, so therefore now they have total of, now as you could see they have seven electrons in its outermost shell of the carbon when we talk in terms of hybridization also. But here we could see that so as to complete octet, one hydrogen has been needed. So therefore it has not been completely octet, it is incomplete octet. And that's the reason that it requires one electron that makes the carbon atom electron deficient. And it is in a very urge to get an electron that makes it very unstable. So this is what we have talked about, its instability. But now let us talk about the structure. So since it has been giving the sp2 hybridization, the carbon is giving sp2 hybridized. So that is the reason that we could get a structure which is nothing but a planar, that is a triangular planar structure that we could get. So we could write it in this way, that is from a top view that we could get the view in this way, that is it is sort of p orbitals and a hybrid orbitals, that is sp2 hybridized, and each orbital that we could get, this is sp2 hybridized orbital, this is sp2 and even this is 2. So this is the one that we have got, that is sp2 hybrid orbitals. And talking about the next one, that is the hydrogen that would occupy, that is 1s. So again, this is the hydrogen that is 1s orbital, and again this is 1s, and again this is 1s, but having an extra electron. So in terms of, suppose this is a top view that we have got, and suppose in another view, suppose if we want to describe it, so we could say in this way, where the carbon is here, one of the hydrogen is present over here, while the next, so this is not, I can't draw a 3D diagram in this 2D paper, but so somewhere I could maintain this kind of formula so as to represent the structure of the methyl radical. And the overall bond angle that it would be present over here is basically 120 degree, and even here also. But since we have got to know that is one p orbital has been still remaining with an electron in it, so therefore we could mention it over like this one, that is it consists of a p orbital, and that is not empty, that consists of one electron. So that one electron basically is odd electron, and that makes the overall methyl to be more unstable. So this is the structure of the methyl radical that I wanted to explain, and that's it. This was we have understood what is free radical. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you will have got to know that's what is actually free radical. So share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to EKD channel. Thank you so much.